Hey, now this is more like it. It's beautiful, Scree.
Rather more to your taste than Solemn, eh?
You said it. Just caught the sunset, too. Wow.
The skies are always golden here.
Okay, we'll write the brochure later. We're on business.
Precisely. Come on, then. Let's head for the water.
As in us in the water?
Naturally.
One thing you should know, Scree. The girl can't swim.
You can't swim?
Oh. And you can, I suppose, a great hunk of rock?
I don't need to swim. Why go to all that trouble? I just sink to the bottom and walk.
This I must see.
Aquis is a water-filled realm, Jen. I was rather hoping... Well, I thought you mortals were...
Yeah, well, the city I'm from isn't a water-filled realm, okay? Of course, most parents took the trouble to get their kids out swimming. Some even went horse riding, too. Girl Scouts, tap classes. With me, you get none of that extracurricular crap, okay?
I'm sorry.
What is that sound?
I'm not sure, but I believe it's coming from the middle of the lagoon, wouldn't you say?
Guess so.
You know, the Undyne are a very cultured race, aquatic creatures, intelligent, great allies to Arella.
Like you say, intelligent.
And I gather they're extremely resourceful. Aquis isn't naturally the easiest place for them to survive. You may have guessed, I'm not a total expert on this realm, so maybe I should do a little exploring and report back.
Sure. I'll just settle down here and take in some rays. Good luck, Rocky. Sink and walk. Wait till they get that in the Olympics.
Hello, can you hear me? I said hello, hey, can you hear me?
Inokawa M. Scree.
Hello, Scree. I am Aino.
Aino? Oh, so you share a name with the Queen of the Realm. That's right, isn't it? You Undyne have a Queen, Aino.
Oh, stupid, what a fool. Please forgive my rudeness, Highness. I did not think a queen would be here. Highness, I... What the fan is this contraption?
There is no way in, Scree.
Well, how do you get out then?
This is my prison cell, Scree. I am to remain in here until the time of my sacrifice.
You're to be killed? But why?
A malady has fallen upon our people. A terrible plague of the body and mind. Almost all of my people have succumbed. But not I. It was decided that I be placed in this machine to appease the Leviathans, the gods of the sea.
That's terrible.
It is an honor. What greater way to serve my people?
This was your choice?
It was King Adaro's decree. My husband was one of the first to fall to the plague. I am prepared for my fate, Scree.
Forgive my impertinence, but it is superstitious nonsense to suppose that your death could remedy a disease. Surely your realm would be better served by discovering the source. Is there some contagion? Something tainting the water, perhaps?
Unlikely. The water in our lagoons is filtered through vast machines.
I can't let you die like this. Let me try to free you. Please let my companion and I try to get to the bottom of all this. Ah, one thing, Your Majesty. My companion is ill-equipped for life in your world. I had to leave her on the surface.
One of the dry ones.
Yes, a mortal. You know how fussy they are about breathing.
Put your hand to the glass, Scree. Pass this gift on to your friend. Warn her to seek out water before adopting our form.
Thank you, Aino. I will return. Jen?
Oh, you're back. I'd throw you a towel, but... So, how'd it go, Rockster?
I think I know what's going on here. And there's someone I want you to meet.
What's with the arm?
Oh, yes. Well, before you meet her, I've brought you back a gift.
A present?
Yes. Yes. It's a surprise.
Damn right it is. So, what is it? Show me.
No, I say we do this properly. Jen, a gift is a gift, after all.
Are you all right, Scree? You sure you've not got that deep sea, whatchacallit, ringing in the ear stuff?
No, I'm fine. So, close your eyes, hold out your hands.
You are kidding.
Now, don't spoil the fun. Come on.
Unbelievable. You're a grown-up rock now, remember? All right, go on.
Jen, sorry, I really... There was no other way. I didn't think you'd want to after the last time, and I mean, you've always wanted to swim, yes? I'm so stupid. What's wrong with me today? Jen, dive into the water! You're supposed to be in the water before you transform! Quickly!
Ooh, Scree, you really are the most pathetic, stupid, selfish lump of granite I have ever... Ugh!
I heard that.
What?
The Undyne communicate through telepathy. Breathing's no problem either. And I don't know if you've noticed, but you're swimming.
I don't know if you've noticed, but you are in the doghouse.
Hate me later. Right now, I think we may have a problem. Queen Aino, she's dying!
Help me. Help me.
We've got to get that contraption down somehow. Scree?
The cage must be operated by a separate mechanism. There was nothing in the tower itself. I pray we're not too late.
It's not too late as long as she's alive.
If you need my assistance, don't forget to use the summoning stones to bring me over to you.
You okay?
I am alive.
Well, that falls into the okay category. Your Majesty, I've never seen anyone as strong as you. You just wouldn't give up.
I knew suddenly. It wasn't right to be dying in that way.
I've got to say, Your Majesty.
Aina.
Thanks. No, I gotta tell you, I have to tell you, I have never seen my little friend ever get like that. I mean, when you were in trouble there, he was going crazy. You must have made quite an impression.
I'm listening, Jen. Be careful what you say.
This telepathy can really suck.
Queen Aino, it's true that I am more than content to know you are safe again.
You see? For him, that's positively gushing.
I will never be able to thank you adequately for what you have done. Your resourcefulness, simply your goodness. I shan't forget. Now, I am queen of this realm, and have been deprived of seeing my beloved Aquis for far too long. Will you swim with me, Jen?
You try and stop me. This swimming, it could catch on. Aino? Okay?
I sense danger, Jen. This is what we Undyne have always dreaded.
What is it?
I must go no further. The waters ahead are tainted. I can sense it. As your friend wisely surmised, there is a contagion.
It's polluted through there?
The Undyne have worked miracles to survive through time. The waters of Aquis are naturally poisonous to our race, but our lagoons and bay are protected, purified by our filtering machines. Without that system, the Undyne are doomed. The plague that has befallen us. I didn't dream it was possible. Could be due to the system's failure. And if we listen, the machines are silent.
Aino, return to the other side of the lagoon. We need you in the very safest water. Arella warned us that there was something terrible going on. That's why we're here. I'll get those purifying machines switched on.
That will be no easy task, I assure you. You must take care, Jen. But the Undyne are now in no position to refuse your help. You have our thanks. Begin at the priming station. That would be the first stage to restarting our system. And for that, we need to get you into the bay. Two of my kind are required to open this door. Goodbye, Jen. And please be careful. Adaro will be through there. My husband was first to succumb to the madness that the plague has wrought upon our people.
Okay. And you stay safe, too. I'll kickstart that motor of yours before you know it. Map of the purifying system. The markings must be the substations.
Thank you.
Okay, that's one of the cogs aligned. Right. I just need to activate the master switch now. To get those substations activated. Thank you. You thinking what I'm thinking?
We've just met King Adaro?
Right. Lewis's drummer gets like that after his fifth shot of Jack.
The poor Undyne Adaro was attacking must have been dead for days.
Well, if he does that to him, just think what he'd be like with us.
I suggest we hurry up and get these waters purified. But I doubt we've seen the last of King Adaro.
Scree, could you give me some help here?
Bye.
Okay, we've got to get this thing going right now. See how that stuff was spreading?
I'll check the master switch and get ready to turn it on. Something wrong? Who are you?
I am Arturo, substation engineer.
Let's get him out of there.
What happened?
A terrible demon came here. Began attacking us. Killed everyone else. He disabled our equipment. Doomed my people. I was able to escape and hide here, but now I'm trapped. Soon, I will join my brothers. All my days, I've never known the turbines silent. The water is very bad now. You must get the pumps working.
There must be some way out.
Believe me, I am no hero. There is no choice. At least now, I will hear those turbines one last time. Know that my race will survive.
Your queen will be proud of you.
What are you doing?
I'm going to get the pumps working.
And what about him?
There is nothing we can do. And we have no time. The water is poisoning the population as we speak.
So you're just gonna kill him?
Jen, he knows the sacrifice he's making. We're talking about an entire race, Jen, and probably all of Oblivion. You can't put all that at risk for one Undyne.
You just watch me.
We have no choice!
I said no, Scree. We are not turning this thing on until he is out of there. Now you can either keep arguing, which is pointless, or you can help me figure out how to get him out of there.
Or I could just step past and turn on the switch. So, how do we get him out?
That's my Rocky.
Well?
I'm working on it.
I can't turn this on without chopping up Arturo. I kill him, Jen kills me.
Thank you.
I need to find a way to get into that control room. The lid won't open. It looks different to the others we've seen.
Thank you, my friends. Thank you.
too shallow to dive in.
Nearly there now, Jen. The main controls will be at the top of this tower.
Cool.
Doubtless, such an important switch will require some sort of key. Well, we'll soon find out.
You say key? You realize, Rocky, we've just got ourselves locked in here.
Oh, never mind for now. Our first priority is to get the machinery going.
And straight in at the top, a brand new number one priority.
Jen, help me with this wheel. It will open up the vents. I think that's it.
I must say, you really did...
Beat the crap out of him?
Fight with great distinction.
Uh-huh.
Ah, yes, here.
Guess I just killed the sheriff.
It's the Undying Key. This will get the machinery started.
And get us out of here, I hope. That's it, Rocky boy, we've done it!
Oh yes, the motor's working will be music to Aino's ears.
Don't think we Undyne have ears.
Soon the waters will be pure again, and Undyne life will return to normal.
For the survivors it will, but we haven't seen too many of them.
Jen? Scree. There are more survivors than you imagine. You can hear a signal to my people telling them it is safe to return to the lagoon. Many have fled to secret waters, which are full of different perils. Not all will have escaped those dangers, but most will return safely.
That's great, Aino. Really great. I'm only sorry your husband had to... that he had to die for all this to come right. I'm sorry.
He died long ago, when the affliction first came on. It wasn't my Adaro that you killed. All you should feel now is pride. We have everything to thank you for.
It has been an honor.
I hope you may return to our kingdom one day.
I'd like that. Goodbye, Queen Aino.
Jennifer, Scree, you have both done much to commend yourselves.
Hey, no problem.
Thank you.
Do you believe me now, Jennifer? That Abaddon is a danger to these realms, and that he and his agents must certainly be stopped?
Oh, he's bad news, Aurella, I see that. But it's cool. He tried to mess up Solom and Aquis, and... me and the big guy here just cruised on in and made things right. You know, end a problem.
I wish it were that easy, Jennifer. But there are more far-reaching repercussions of these disturbances. Each of these imbalances allow the armies of chaos to grow and spread.
Oh, here we go.
You are far from the end of your journey, Jennifer.
No! I can't keep bailing you guys out, okay? I got my own priorities. I need to find Lewis and get back home. Look, I've helped you plenty now, Aurella. And I don't mind cause I like you, but for me, this is the end of the line.
Jen, I'm sure that...
Hold on, mister. Cause I'm talking to you too. And I mean back there. Yeah, okay. I know you did the right thing in the end, but without me, you were gonna put that guy through the blender. Victory at all costs. And then shouting at me not being ready to make sacrifices. Well, I'm telling you, I've made enough.
No, Jen, no, that's not what I was saying. It wasn't about you.
And while I'm at it, Aurella, don't you think, as the so-called leader of the forces of order, that you've been just a little bit negligent? Or was it part of your plan that the fate of the world end up in the hands of an overgrown garden gnome and a goddamn waitress?
Jennifer, Scree deserves better than to be talked to like that.
Whatever. I've had it.
What do you know about your parents, Jennifer?
What?
You never knew them, did you?
How do you know that?
You are a hybrid, Jennifer. Half mortal, half demon. One of only two in all existence. And to me, that makes you more important than an army of demons. Did you think it was just those trinkets on your arms that allowed you to change form? You have powers even Abaddon does not fully comprehend. You can go anywhere, do things that Belazor could not if he had a millennium. The laws of the Nexus are yours to break. And Lewis is the same.
You're lying.
I had an army once, Jennifer. Just after you were born, I lost it all in a battle to wrest two infants away from Abaddon. Only my general, bravest and strongest of my warriors, escaped the slaughter. And he fled the battlefield to hide you and Lewis in Mortalis. He was captured on his return, and Abaddon gave him to his warlord Belazor so that they might learn of your location. He endured monstrous torments at their hands, but he never spoke a single word as to your whereabouts. Eventually, after many years of torture, he was able to disguise himself and make his escape. To this day, he is believed by our enemies to be dead. Through sheer force of will, he had projected his spirit into the nearby form of a small stone effigy.
Scree. Why didn't he say something?
It is not his way. Do you see now why you must go on?
I'm scared, Arella.
You must not be. This is your destiny, Jennifer. Are you willing to continue?
I guess so.
Scree?
Ladyship.
Loyal Abdazur, guide Jennifer on into the realm of Aether. Abaddon has bestowed a dark gift upon its people.
But, only if you're not sick of the sight of me.
It would be an honor.
This makes me glad. But hurry. I may not have a presence in the Nexus by the time you return. Go now.